Hi, this is Julian from Minute Earth. The pandemic had some surprising effects on our air quality. As the world locked down, traffic and air travel nearly ground to a halt and many factories shut down. As a result, outdoor air quality improved. 5 months in, the amount of particulate matter and nitrogen dioxide dropped by 31% and 60% globally. But most of us weren't out and about in the fresher air. Thanks to remote working, learning, and socializing, we've been at home, indoors, a lot more. An average of 20% more early in the pandemic. And while outside, nasty airborne stuff can disperse and be carried away by wind or rain, inside, it's trapped, especially as we build ever more airtight homes for energy efficiency. As a result, pollutants can build up, and they are often 2 to 5 times more concentrated in your living room than on the street right outside. Plus, while at home, we've been inadvertently doing more of the things that release the worst of these toxins, like cooking, which we've been doing twice as much as we were pre-pandemic. Many of the fuels we cook with can release dangerous gases or fine lung-coating particles, sometimes at levels more than 100 times higher than is considered safe. And many cooking methods, even just burning your food, which I count as a cooking method, can release cancer-linked particles from the food itself. We've also been scrubbing down every scrubbable surface in our homes with every cleaning product we can find in an effort to keep our homes virus-free. But ironically, all this cleaning has made our air dirtier. That's because some of the chemicals in these products can react with other cleaning products, dirty surfaces, or chemicals already present in the air to produce some pretty nasty pollutants. For example, ozone in the air can break apart the carbon-carbon bonds in some molecules that make up the cleaning products. The fragments then quickly combine with oxygen or other compounds to form pollutants like formaldehyde. All this sounds pretty scary, especially when you consider that even before the pandemic-inspired rise in cooking and cleaning, a study of air quality in US homes found that in a worst-case indoor air scenario, the cancer risk would be, quote, unacceptable at US hazardous waste sites. Yeesh. Over the past few decades, we've become more aware of the risks of indoor air pollution, and the respiratory dangers posed by the COVID pandemic may well be the push we need to make long overdue changes to our habits and the places we inhabit, which should help us all breathe a little easier. Want an expert opinion on how to improve air quality in your house? We did too, so I asked our sponsor, Lydol, whose mission is to create a cleaner, quieter, and safer world. They recommend opening windows or doors to bring in fresh air, using air purifiers with HEPA filters, and putting a MERV 13 or higher filter in your heating or air conditioning system. These filters trap microscopic particles, including bacteria and many viruses. Even pre-pandemic, I used them here in Montana to trap ultra-fine soot during fire season. We're glad to be sponsored by Lydol because they're one of the world's only manufacturers of filtration material for N95 and surgical masks. Last year, they supported the production of nearly 1 billion face masks, and now they're using their new Filtration Center of Excellence to advance filtration science to continuously improve standards for air quality all around the world. You can learn more at Lydol.com. From the top of our lungs, thanks Lydol.